Here. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a minute. Okay, so this is your ISC. Okay, this is your short circuit current you had calculated. This is your ISC. Okay, and with that ISC, RTH is here. Okay, and RL is here. So they are basically connected in parallel. Okay, so that's why if you apply the current divider rule, that will save your time. Okay. Clear.
So we can find through a mesh analysis also now.
Find out whatever to follow, branch current method, node analysis, mesh analysis. But if you apply mesh analysis, then you have to form two equation.
Yes, sir.
So then yes, then if you have two equations, then again you have to solve those equations. So basically you are wasting your valuable time during your exam. Try to minimize your calculation. That's why I showed you types of numerical and their process. Okay, basic thought is jitna kam equation hoga utna kam tumko matlab parishram karna padega kuch bhi value nikalne ke liye. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
है ना, तो जितना तो मेरा ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या रहेगा, मेरा मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव है कि मुझे नंबर ऑफ इक्वेशन को रिड्यूस करना है. तो वो कैसे करेंगे, उसके लिए जस्ट एक करंट डिवाइडर रूल लगा देंगे, बस हो जाएगा. मेश एनालिसिस से कर सकते हो, इट विल गिव यू इक्वली राइट आंसर, बट टाइम ज्यादा थोड़ा लगेगा, नथिंग एल्स.
सर मेस एनालिसिस में हम लोग कार्डिनल्स रूल लगाएंगे या सब्स्टिट्यूशन पे वो कर लेंगे?
नो, सब्स्टिट्यूशन में तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. सब्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोसेस अगर यूज करोगी तो उसमें एट ए टाइम वन सोर्स तुमको कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा.
सर लेकिन वो सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड में अगर दो से ज्यादा रहेगा तब तो प्रॉब्लम होगा ना, तो कार्डिनल्स रूल लगा
सकते हैं. कार्डिनल्स रूल यस यू कैन अप्लाई, बट दैट इज yes you can apply, no problem. Okay, but see, if there are more than two sources, then it will be given like one current source, two voltage source. So dekho kya mujhe, hum log kya pata hai ki current source jab hum replace karenge tab wo ho jayega open circuit. To tumhare liye to calculation aur bhi aasan ho gaya, kyunki open circuit ke through to koi current jayega nahi, है ना. तो सुपरपोजिशन में करना आसान होगा आई थिंक. ठीक है, कार्डिनल्स रूल है वो कोई प्रोसेस नहीं है. ठीक है, वो कैलकुलेशन में हेल्प करेगा. ओके, यू कैन अप्लाई. ओके, बट अगर सुपरपोजिशन लिख दिया रहा कि यू हैव टू सॉल्व दिस न्यूमेरिकल यूजिंग द सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम और थेवेनिन थ्योरम, देन स्ट्रिक्टली यू हैव टू फॉलो द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस ऑफ दैट थ्योरम. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any more query regarding the first module? Because I when will be your exam? Fourth or fifth?
Sir, both modules are coming now.
No. Next, only module sir. One. I already informed that in the group. Check the group. Okay. Check the group. I already wrote there that module one is in your class test one. Okay, so it's almost 3:08. So without any delay, we are directly going to the transformer. Okay, just a minute. I have one animation to show you before starting.
Sir, students are waiting.
No one is waiting here. No one is here. Okay, just a minute. Where is that? Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Yes, sir. Fine. So look, this is the animation that I downloaded from YouTube. That is the best animation till now. Okay, as per my observation. So what is electrical transformer that is written here? And I already told you that it is a kind of static device, right? That is working at constant frequency, at constant power function. It converts, it transforms one voltage level to another. Okay? Never say that transformer is a device that is used for step up condition or step down. Never say that. It is a static device that works at constant frequency. Power transfer is constant and it is used to convert one voltage level to another. Okay, now look, just a minute. Now, what is the principle that is used here? The principle is the induction process. Okay, just a minute. It is called the mutual induction. Look here. Right? Now, this is the power transfer. Okay. And in case of transformer, the power supply is always constant, right? So if you are increasing the voltage level, okay, any problem? Okay, fine. So if you increase the voltage level, look here, if you increase the voltage level, the current will decrease simultaneously, okay? And if the current level is decreased, the heat loss becomes less because H equals to I square R. That is the Joule's law. You already know that. Okay. So that's why when power is transmitted from the source, that means from the power station, okay, like Maithan DVC, your Durgapur, Damodar Valley Corporation, okay. Durgapur, your Mejia thermal power plant. So they always try to send the power with higher voltage level. It's constant. Okay. So if you increase the voltage level, current decrease ho jayega. Or current agar decrease hua, toh heat loss ho jayega kam. So your power transmission mein jo power aayega tumhare paas, minus heat loss. That is your ultimate received पावर. ओके, तो वो जो पावर तुमको मिलेगा वो रिलेटिवली यहां पे हीट लॉस कम हो रहा है. सो द रिसीव्ड पावर विल बी मच मोर, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सेंडिंग पावर एंड द रिसीविंग पावर, द डिफरेंस विल बी वेरी लेस इफ योर करेंट लेवल इज लेस. ओके, नाउ सो दैट्स व्हाई द ट्रांसफॉर्मर इज यूज्ड टू सेंड at high voltage. Okay, when you are using that transformer to transmit the power, then the voltage is always kept high so that the current value becomes low at constant power. Now, this is the primary coil, NP number of turns, and this one is the secondary coil, NS. Okay, NP is the input coil, NS is the output coil. Clear? Now, look, this is the principle of working. Okay, here, look, it is a AC device. The transformer is not at all working in DC, right? So, here, this direction of current always changes. Time to time, look carefully. Okay, see, the current direction is changing, and likewise due to the current flow to that coil, the magnetic lines are created. Okay, so, and look, some magnetic lines are passed through the secondary coil. Just a minute, look here. Okay, the direction is changing. Look, now due to the mutual induction process, here also some amount of current is induced. Okay, and due to that current flow as a byproduct, that secondary flux is getting created. Okay, now due to that creation of flux and due to the current flowing through the secondary coil, due to LdIdt, a secondary voltage is created. This is your secondary voltage waveform. Okay, now so this is the total working function of the transformer. Clear? Okay, till now do you have any question? Till now do you have any question or everything is clear? Hello, is that clear?
Yes,
to you?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Okay, fine. So next, this is the core. Okay, this white is the core and you can see the fine lines. Okay, fine lines. So that line shows you that number of lamina. Okay, that a thin plate of iron or steel is pasted one after another and that will form this kind of core. Okay, and that blue line, that okay, now it, this is the lamina. Okay, the number of lamina depends here. Okay, and it is done to reduce the eddy current loss. Okay, this lamination is done to reduce the eddy current loss. New number of laminas are pasted with each other so that the eddy current loss is less, right? And I hope you see this blue lines. Okay, this is the direction of the alternating flux. This blue lines here decides the nature of the alternating flux. Okay, now this is the direction of the magnetic field created due to the alternating current flow through that core. Okay, and each time it is changing. And this is the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, also it is alternating in nature. Actually, you can say that this from the direction of flux, from the direction of current flow, what will be the magnetic lines of force? You can easily tell that. Okay, so that is the basic construction and working function of the transformer. Okay, now two types of conditions I already discussed. First one is step up, second one is step down. So what is step up condition? When secondary voltage is higher than the primary voltage. Okay, and what is step down? The reverse one. There is nothing to discuss. Okay, now the VP, I also told him. Okay, now here you are getting this ES by EP equals to NS by NP. Okay, so from here you can say that the voltage the EMF generated is directly proportional to the number of turns. Okay. So that's it. So now we are directly going to the theoretical part. Okay. Okay, so the working function, the basic work function of the transformer and the production of flux, is that clear to everyone? Okay. So now we are directly going to the module transformers. Okay. So this was the previous numerical I told you to try that. Now, first we will solve this one, then the next part. The first one is the 25 kVA single phase transformer has 250 turns on primary and 40 turns on the secondary winding. The primary is connected to 1500 volt and 50 hertz mains. So calculate the primary and secondary currents on full load. Secondary EMF you have to calculate and maximum flux in the core. Okay, so what is this 25 kVA? It is the rating. It is the VA rating of the transformer. Okay, and what is the type? It is single phase transformer. Okay, in numerical, if it is written like this, okay, if it is written like this, then it also denotes that it is single phase transformer. Okay, now 250 turns on the primary, so I can write NP as 250, and 40 turns on the secondary winding. So is it step up or step down condition? Tell me.
Step down.
Step down.
Step down. Right. Because from the number of turns, you can easily say that whether it is working as step up condition or step down condition. Now, the primary is 1500 volt. So, usually using that, this equation that V1 by V2 equals to N1 by N2 or VP by VS equals to NP by NS. Okay, so using that equation, you can easily calculate the value of V2, right? Next, the primary current, and since the total rating, the total transfer of power from primary to secondary is always constant. So nothing to worry. In primary, total VA is 25 K, and in secondary also. Okay, what is kVA? That is nothing but the multiplication of voltage into current. Okay, so that's how we are getting this kVA. It is nothing, it is you can say that it is 25 k, that means 25 kilo volt ampere. Okay, that is not, it's not I, that is A. Okay, volt into ampere. So voltage, you know, now ampere you can calculate easily, right? So these two things you can calculate. Now next one is the calculation of flux. From this equation you can find out that E RMS, because it is always RMS. Okay, E max RMS equals to 4.44 F pi max into number of turns. So now this equation will change for primary, like that in place of N you can say NP, in secondary you can say NS, right? So here primary voltage is given, so from there you can calculate the pi M value, that is 0.027 Weber. Okay, so this numerical is very simple to calculate, and this type of numerical can be given of maximum 5 marks. Okay, now today we will discuss the impedance transformer. Okay, what is impedance transformer? it is like in it is just different from the ideal case. Okay, in case of ideal condition, what we consider that in primary there is no resistance, in secondary there is no resistance. Okay, now we have included one here. Okay, so that value is suppose Z1, we have included. Okay, so if you want to convert that Z1 is now here in primary. Now if you want to calculate this value in secondary, then what will be the impedance value? Okay, so that is our main objective in impedance transformer, right? Is that clear? Because we are going to calculate the Z value, the impedance value of the primary with respect to secondary and vice versa. How we can calculate? Okay, if you look from the secondary side, value of the resistance or impedance that we need to find out. If you look from the primary and there is one impedance in the secondary, what will be the value with respect to primary? Okay, so that value we are going to calculate now. That is impedance transformer. Okay, so now look, an impedance Z2 is connected across the secondary winding at its output. Okay, this one is connected here. So I am erasing this one. Okay, so here Z2 is connected across the secondary. You can see this. This is your Z2 connected, right? And now you are looking from the primary portion. So what will be the value of Z2? What will you see? Okay, that you have to find out. How will you find out? So we need a process. We need the concept of turn ratio, right? Now V1 is the primary voltage given here and V2 is the secondary voltage generated here. Okay, E1 is the EMF developed in primary, E2 is the EMF developed in secondary. Okay, so we can say that E1 by E2 equals to N1 by N2, where N1 is the turn in primary, turn in secondary. So that is the turn ratio. Okay, so from here, can I say that the power is constant? Okay, power is constant. So I can say that V1 I1 equals to V2 into I2. Can I say this? Please reply.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, can I write V1 by V2 equals to I2 by I1 equals to K? I can write this also?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Now, what is this Z2 value? Can I write that V2 by I2 equals to Z2? I can say this because look, the voltage here is V2 and how much current is flowing? I2. So V2 by I2 equals to Z2. Okay, now V2 is here, okay, V2 by I2 equals to Z2, that is already derived. Okay, now what I can say that V1 by I1 equals to z1. Okay, so v1 by i1 equals to z1. Okay, what is the value of z1? Z1 is the impedance that we observe from this primary side. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now our work is to create a relation between z1 and z2. Then only I can say that yes, z2 yahan par hai. Z1 हमको कैलकुलेट करना है, कैसे करेंगे? सो हम लोगों को क्रिएट करना पड़ेगा एक रिलेशन बिटवीन Z1 एंड Z2. हाउ कैन वी क्रिएट दैट? ओके, हाउ कैन वी क्रिएट दैट? नाउ सी व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ V1, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ V1 by V2, that is K. Okay, now what is the value of I1 by I2? That is 1 by K. Okay, now I am dividing this one, like V1 by V2 divided by I1 by I2. Okay, so from here this K will be K square. Okay, clear? So from here I can say that, okay, I need to erase this one. Okay, so from here I can write that V1 by I1, okay, divided by V2 by I2 equals to K square. Can I write this? Is it okay? Check everyone. Okay, so from here I yes. can derive that what is V1 by I1? That is Z1. Okay, what is V2 by I2? That is Z2. And here it is K square. So from here I can say that if you have the value of Z2 and from the primary you are calculating the impedance, then I can say that Z1 equals to Z2 square, Z2 into K2 square. Okay, that is Z2 into K square. Okay, so this is the relation that you have to remember. This is very important equation. Okay, in case of impedance transformer, this one is very important. Suppose you know the value of Z1. Okay, you need to calculate the value of Z2. So from here you can easily get the answer. Okay, look here. In place of Z1, it is written as Z2 dash. Both are same. Okay, so this condition is called the impedance with respect to primary, because from where you are looking from primary. So if it is written like this, Z1 or Z2 prime equals to K square into Z2, then it is called the impedance with respect to primary. Okay, it is called impedance with respect to primary. Now, if you write like this, that Z2 equals to Z1 by K square, then this writing is impedance with respect to secondary. Okay, it means what? Z1 is present in the system and you are calculating the Z2 value. Okay, so that is the impedance with respect to secondary. So that is the main objective of impedance transformer. Okay, so do one numerical. Okay, I am giving one numerical. Try to solve this. I need to stop sharing the screen. Where is that? Okay. Now it is showing. Okay, is the screen visible? Check everyone, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So now, do I have a blank copy? Okay, I can do that. Okay, so try to solve this. Okay, there is one only resistance here, value is 1 ohm. Okay, in this transformer, it is said that the transformer is 220 by 440 volt, okay, 15 kVA, 50 hertz, okay. Okay, everyone try to solve this because this numerical, I am just drawing here. Okay, yes, any query?
Yes, not visible, anything.
Visible, okay. But, okay, just a minute.
Yes, sir. Now.
Okay. Now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So here, 15 kVA, 220 by 440 volt transformer, 15 hertz. In primary, this is your primary side. Okay. In primary side, 1 ohm is your resistance, and in secondary, the load is. The load is, suppose, just a minute. In secondary, another resistance of 2 ohm and inductor is 3 J ohm. Okay, so now you have to find out that you are looking from secondary. Okay, so what is the value of Z2? That means you have to find out the impedance with respect to secondary. Okay, calculate this one. See, this numerical is not in any kind of book. Okay, so I just come up with this value. So basically, I don't know the correct answer. Okay, so try to solve it right now. Okay, because this is your primary value, 1 ohm. This is the secondary value, 2 ohm and 3 J ohm. So you have to find out the Z2. That means with respect to secondary, what is your impedance? Okay.
Sir, half of the question is not visible.
Yes, again, sir. Is...
Yeah.
Okay. just a minute. Okay, now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
Now you have the secondary resistance, secondary impedance, that is 2 ohm and 3 J ohm, right? And in primary, only one resistor is there, right? So you have to find out the impedance with respect to secondary. Okay, so without any calculation, just tell me what should we do. First, tell me that. What should
sir, we will do V1 by I1 is equals to V2 by I2.
See, V1 by I1 equals to V2 by I2, that concept is already known to you. And from that concept, you develop that formula. Okay, that is Z1 equals to K square into Z2. Yes?
Yes, sir.
So use that formula. Okay. So what you need to do, this 1 ohm, it should be transferred to the secondary. Okay, what is the meaning of impedance with respect to secondary? It means that, okay, so it is not clearly visible when I full screen this one. Yeah. So I need to draw that. Just a minute. Right. So what is the basically meaning of this impedance transformer? See, if Z2 is here, okay, if this is the, okay, I am taking the reference of the previous numerical, okay, that I gave you. Everyone, I hope you have drawn that numerical in your copy, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the meaning of with respect to secondary? This is your original. Transformer, okay, where in primary 1 ohm is present. If I want to calculate the impedance with respect to secondary, okay, with respect to secondary, then it means that instead of this 1 ohm, okay, instead of this 1 ohm, some resistance I can connect here. It is the meaning of with respect to secondary. Okay, here at first 1 ohm was connected. Okay, so 1 ohm is your Z1 here. So calculate the Z2. What is the value of Z2? And what is the value of K? K is V1 by V2. So here that will be 220 by 440. 1 by 2. Correct? So Z2 value will be Z1 by K square. So if it is Z1 by K square, then I can write the, what is the value of Z1? 1 into 2 square. That means 4. Okay. So instead of writing 1 ohm here, 1 ohm here, if I write 4 ohm in secondary, it will give you similar characteristic of this transformer. Now is this clear? What is the meaning of with respect to secondary or with respect to primary?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That means without, if you omit any resistance, any element from primary, and you are writing the with respect to secondary impedance value here, then they will give you the same characteristic. Okay, so like the previous numerical that I gave you, okay, in that previous numerical, now I am drawing the circuit. Okay, now I am drawing the circuit. Just a minute. This is your 1 ohm original. Okay, here 2 ohm is present. And this one is how much? This much is, this one is inductor value. What is the value of inductance?
3J, sir.
3J. Okay. So 3J here. I want to calculate the impedance with respect to secondary. So only I need to convert the 1 ohm. Okay. So if you want to convert, if you want to transfer the 1 ohm from primary to secondary, 4 ohm will be present in the secondary. Correct? How? That this 4 ohm will be present in the secondary. I am drawing the circuit now in the at the top. Okay. This is your primary. There is no element now because I just transferred the primary resistance into the secondary. Okay. First is your 4 ohm. Okay. Second, the secondary coils. Okay, so now if you check, what is your Z2 value now? That is 4 plus 2, 6. Okay, so your referred to secondary or with respect to secondary value, that is your Z2 value, is 6 plus 3J ohm. Is that concept clear or not? Or do I need to repeat? Is this concept clear?
Yes.
Or do I need to repeat? Okay, so that is the main concept of impedance transformer. That means if you convert the resistance or inductance of primary and transfer that into secondary, what will be your newest value if you look from the secondary? So that is called referred to secondary or with respect to secondary. Okay, so both are equally correct. So sometimes it is called impedance with respect to primary or with respect to secondary here. Whatever we calculated, it is called the impedance referred to secondary or impedance with respect to secondary. Okay. So with this, I am concluding today's class.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, here Z2 equal to Z1 by K2 K square.
Right.
Sir, how 1 into K square there?
Your K value is 1 by 2.
Yes, sir.
Right. So when you calculate the K square in denominator, it is.
Yes, sir.
1 by 2 whole square. So the 2 will come to the numerator.
Yes, sir.
Then okay. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So all of you give your attendance in the chat box. Thank you everyone for attending the class. And sir, if you have given your attendance, you may leave the meeting. Your class is officially over.
Happy birthday, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Happy birthday, sir.
Happy birthday, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Happy birthday, sir.
Happy birthday, sir.
Thank you very
happy
much
sir.
To all of you.
Happy birthday, sir.
Happy birthday, sir.
Happy birthday, sir.
मिस कर लो नहीं फेसबुक आ जाएगी।